ever since I was little, I never thought that whatever my dad was doing, that he was wrong. I just loved him so much that whatever he was doing, I was okay with that, and I didn't took it personally. And then my little sister was born, and I don't know why, but I took it personally, and I can't open really my heart to her.
It isn't really her that you're not opening your heart to. It is really a little deeper level of you. There is more to you than what you have found and related to in yourself. There is also you in what is represented outside of yourself. For you to see what your little sister is for you to be seeing from within a little bit more of you, relating from a little bit more of you, for you to love your little sister, is for you to be landed in your heart, in coming from a little bit more of you. It isn't really her. It is really you.
So it is personally then.
The more open you are within, the more capacity you'll have to really meet with something outside of yourself. To know, to see, to meet, and to love. For you to love her includes more of you. It requires more of you within for you to love her. If you have difficulty in loving her, your difficulty is really in opening deeper within, realizing more of you. That does really relate to knowing her, seeing her, meeting her, and loving her. In this way, your relationship with her shows you something of your relationship with you. In that way, how you are with her is how you are with you.
I can see that.
Then you see her. And in seeing her, you see you. There's much more to you than what you're used to.
I used to be always on my own and figuring things out by myself.
That's what you're used to. What you're used to doesn't represent all of you. It doesn't represent all of reality. There's much more to you than what you have experienced. There's much more to you than what you can see. There's much more to you than what you relate to. When you release what confines you, you come into what encompasses you. It's slightly similar and profoundly different.
After the Oktoberfest, we were driving home, and I realized that my heart was opening and opening and opening. And as it was open, I felt so much pain, and I was just scared, and I'm still scared.
It's easy for something to hurt your body. It's difficult for something to hurt yourself. And it isn't possible for anything to hurt you. You're experiencing that you can be hurt is really your experience of your own nervous system. It isn't your experience of yourself, and it isn't your experience of your heart. As your nervous system changes, your experience of what hurts you changes. When you really come to know what your heart is, then you come to realize that within you are not damageable. Even though you can feel everything, and it is okay to feel everything. For you to feel more involves more of you. That makes you feel more vulnerable. It doesn't actually make you more vulnerable. When you protect yourself in the way that you're used to, when you protect your heart in the way that you're used to, you're not actually protecting something. You're actually limiting you and stopping you. You're closing down your actual capacity. Your actual capacity to receive what seems that you're not able to receive. You have your experience, and you make a judgment based on your own experience of what your capacity is within. You misinform yourself in that. Trust something deeper within that you're knowing a little bit. Trust that more than trusting your experience to tell you everything of what is actually occurring. The more you trust, the more you open, the more you feel.
But I trust my body.
When you don't want to feel hurt, you're trusting your nervous system. Your nervous system won't open if you're not opening within your own body. You can open in an instant within all of your body. As you're being that in your own body, it takes time, perhaps even a long time, for your nervous system to open and change as much. When you open in your body beyond what you're comfortable with in your body, you're moving past the comfort zone of your own nervous system. You're stretching your nervous system. When you stretch it, it grows, it opens, it changes. When you stretch a muscle, it isn't comfortable. It hurts. You need to stretch, even though it hurts. You understand the value of stretching. Apply that understanding to stretching yourself, to stretching your own nervous system, to stretching the openness of your heart. All of it hurts. And it's all good. If you're uninformed and you stretch your muscle somewhat and it hurts, it'll be easy for you to think in an uninformed state that you're doing something wrong. And you can make a judgment within to never stretch any muscle because it hurts when you do it. Therefore, you're doing harm to your body when you stretch.
But it's all good.
You know within that opening is good. It's only when pain and hurt accompany the opening that you easily draw the conclusion within that that's damaging you. If you believe what you're thinking in that, you'll secure the conclusion and you'll act on it and you'll stop opening. You'll stop stretching. And everything becomes tight. When you first realize the goodness within of opening, and you're knowing it, you're knowing the truth of it, that knowledge is worth more than the experience that follows. Experience doesn't inform you. Knowledge informs you. There's knowledge that is in the experience. But don't just believe your experience. Don't take it all at face value. Discern what it is within that you are knowing the truth of. In the midst of your experience. Then when you experience something that has you coming into realization, you begin to realize what you are knowing in the midst of your experience.
So when I felt I was opening, I really stretched myself.
And before you felt the pain in that, you knew the truth in that, and you loved it. Don't believe everything that you experience just because you experience it. Discern what you know the truth of in the midst of it. What if you have never worked out before and you decide to work out a little bit and it hurts? and you're somewhat confused. So you tell someone that it hurts. And that person tells you, it's quite all right, keep going. You're quite unsure, but you're trusting. The next day, your whole body is really hurting and really sore. It would be easy for you to draw the conclusion that you are a fool. You shouldn't have done what was hurting. And now you have the proof of it, to never do it again. Stretch yourself and be always giving yourself workouts. Stretch your nervous system. Stretch your mind. Work out your nervous system and your mind.
How? By going running and not stopping after I can't run anymore, just keep on running?
Open within. And as soon as it hurts, don't recoil just because it hurts. Get to know how things actually work within. And then live by what you have come to know the truth of. When someone isn't moving along fast enough for you, and you have to wait, if you feel impatient, impatience hurts. It's uncomfortable. It's another level of hurt. If you listen to the hurt, it will be easy for you to draw the conclusion within that that other person is doing something to you, and that you need to stop what that other person is doing to protect yourself from that hurt. Carefully examine every little way within everything in your life. Carefully examine hurt, and you'll realize how much of it you already understand and you already have perspective in, that you already know the truth of, and that you have grown in that. That you have grown in that immediately tells you that there is much more for you to grow in. Then, based on what you have already realized and learned, love, realizing, and learning, and you won't stop the moment something hurts. You'll realize instead the truth if it is that you love realizing and you love learning. Have that on every level within, that you're capable of having awareness of.
I can see that I have to grow in more, and I don't really know how. Do I just grow by stretching?
Yes. While really listening within, while stretching, there's a lot of information to take in while you're stretching. really open within, and love really listening.
I asked that question because my dad was sitting next to me and he said that I was a man. And then I asked him, like, am I really a man? Because I'm 17, but I don't feel like 17. And he said, yes, of course, but I don't feel like everyone is seeing that. And I don't know how to not present, but how to show more that I'm not a little kid.
Part of you is a little kid. There are aspects of that that need to never go away. And there are other aspects of that that you know within to let go of, that you know within to move past. There's a sorting out in that that also hurts. Don't not sort it out just because there's some hurt in it. Within every stage of your development, there'll be more that you come into that needs to be sorted out. Some of it you actually know within to keep, and some of it you actually know within to let go of. If you're being really sensitive within, you'll keep the good of every stage of development, including that of being a baby. When you find the baby and the little child and the kid in your dad, you love him the more for it.
Yes, that's true.
In knowing that, keep the same true for you. Being 17 years old, if you are all there, really all there, then you are not 17. You are one going on 17.